watching our webcast, would like to remind all members to speak clearly to the microphones for the benefit of those watching at home. Councillor, no, can I ask Councillor Norbury to say a word or two, please?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Can I just say that this week is Show Racism Red Card Week. It's the week where we all wear red, and in particular on Friday, can I just thank the council and the council officers, and particularly Maxine Joyston, for all the arrangements she's made with the walking football and all the donations that have been made to Show Racism the Red Card. We want racism kicked out of football and sport, and racism kicked out of all walks of life. So can I ask the council, councillors from all parties, please, to hold up their Show Racism the Red Card? Can we have racism kicked out wherever it raises its ugly head?
Williams and Cleary.
Thank you. Councillor Tony Jones. successes, notably the naming of Sir David Attenborough Candlelayer by the Duke and Justice of Cambridge and the Oval Cycling Tour of Britain. Both occasions featured wonderful views and an appreciative commentary of Wirral, giving a spotlight on the borough to a worldwide audience. In 2019, Wirral was named as the Borough of Culture, and there have been many special events recently to celebrate this. Mayoress and myself have been privileged to have been invited to amazing places and events. We have explored parts of the world previously unknown to us. Also, some of the events included food festival in Birkenhead Park over the weekend of the 7th and the 8th of September. 7th saw the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra performing in Birkenhead Park, followed the next evening by a concert on the same stage by the Lightning Seeds, the Christians and China Crisis. Thank you to all the officers and their staff who worked tirelessly to facilitate these events. The Mayoress and I continue to see the exceptional work done by volunteers, charity workers and sponsors in the authority. The Council should be greatly appreciative of all the work they do. Thank you.
Supplementary pack under item 10A. Councillor Harrison or Councillor Berry?
Four.
Councillor Bird?
Again.
Councillor Blakely?
Four.
Councillor Gray?
Against.
Councillor Burgess Joyce?
Four.
Councillor Cameron?
Four.
Councillor Cannon?
Against.
Councillor Carubia?
Against.
Councillor Cleary?
Against.
Councillor Clement?
Four.
Councillor Collins?
Four.
Councillor Cook?
Against.
Councillor Corkill?
Against.
Councillor Cottier?
Against.
Councillor Cox?
Four.
Councillor George Davies?
Against.
Councillor Bill Davies?
Against.
Councillor Farrell?
Against.
Councillor Foss?
Against.
Councillor Gardner?
Four.
Councillor Gilchrist?
Against.
Councillor Carl Queenie?
Against.
Councillor Jeff Queenie?
Four.
Councillor Gray?
Against.
Councillor Hackett?
Against.
Councillor Paul Hayes?
Four.
Councillor Stephen Hayes?
Against.
Councillor Andrew Hodgson?
Four.
Councillor Cathy Hodgson?
Four.
Councillor Johnson?
Four.
Councillor Adrian Jones?
Against.
Councillor Chris Jones?
Against.
Councillor Tony Jones?
Against.
Councillor Kelly?
Against.
Councillor Kenny?
Against.
Councillor Leach?
Against.
Councillor Lewis?
Four.
Councillor McLaughlin?
Against.
Councillor McManus?
Against.
Councillor Mitchell?
Against.
Councillor Muspratt?
Against.
Councillor Nolan?
Against.
Councillor Norwood?
Against.
Councillor Bogle?
Four.
Councillor Rennie?
Four.
Councillor Robinson?
Against.
Councillor Rowland?
Four.
Councillor Smith?
Stay.
Councillor Spriggs?
Against.
Councillor Stewart?
Against.
Councillor Sullivan?
Against.
Councillor Usher?
Against.
Councillor Walsh?
Against.
Councillor Watt?
Four.
Councillor Whittingham?
Against.
Councillor Jerry Williams?
Against.
Councillor Steve Williams?
Four.
Councillor Williamson?
Against.
Councillor Wood?
Against.
And Councillor White?
Four.
Thank you, members.
Voting was votes in favour 21, votes against 39, one abstention. So that has failed. Right. We move on to the alternative motion. Could you just say what that is again, Councillor?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I mentioned that in the light of the number of notices of motion and amendments, we potentially consider proper time should be given to those, so in order to allow due consideration, I draw members' attention to Standing Order HQ, which says that the Council adjourn to a specified time and date, or to such time and date as the Mayor may decide after consultation with the leader of the Council. And Standing Order says that, I draw the leader of the Council and is really sure of yourself that all parties are involved in helping to secure a date for the transaction of the business.
Could I have the second again, please?
Okay. Second, Mr. Mayor.
Okay, thank you. Okay. By electronic voting. Yes. Okay.
Mr. Mayor, could I ask the Conservative votes against the recording?
Okay, so we...
Mr. Mayor, point of order. You may all... I find it incredible that the Lib Dems at annual council move that we hold extra council meetings. Well, they voted against. They don't want extra council meetings. Yes, tonight. They've U-turned yet again, complete U-turned again, and they're asking for extra council meetings.
Mr. Mayor, that's on the case, Mayor.
Thank you,
Councillor Andrew Garton.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Right. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Petition to the council regarding the alley situation to the rear of Banks Road and running between Victoria Drive and Riverside West Cabby. Over the past 2 years, a bin park, including a number of large bins used by local businesses, has developed a site, creating serious access problems and also health and safety issues for residents. And they're requesting the urgent or earliest site visit by the officers to discuss the situation.
Now move on to public questions, and there's a 30-minute time limit on this. But I've got two public questions have been received in advance of the meeting. The first question has been submitted by Mrs. Shirley Kay, and I would like to invite her to ask her question.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Thank you, councillors. Would council be prepared to set up relevant scrutiny committees for health, the environment and children in order to give serious consideration to the potential health and environmental implications of existing wireless technology and 5G on the Wirral in the light of the following points. Point one, the huge global opposition to the 5G rollout, including an urgent appeal from 247 international scientists to the EU to halt 5G. This is in addition to other international appeals by thousands of doctors, scientists, and ordinary citizens. Point two, the thousands of peer-reviewed scientific studies that demonstrate harm to human health from radio frequency radiation. This includes increased cancer risk, infertility, learning and memory deficits, and neurological and cardiovascular disorders. Some study examples include a 2018 review in the Lancet, which concluded, the waste of scientific evidence refutes the prominent claim that the deployment of wireless technologies poses no health risks at the currently permitted non-thermal radio frequency exposure levels. There is also Dr. Martin Powell's extensive review of the literature, summarising thousands of studies from around the world. He found 8 distinctive types of harm caused by non-ionising radiation, including 5G. And there's also the 2018 US National Toxicology Programme. This was a $30 million study on cell phone radiation, which found clear evidence of cancer, heart disease, damage and DNA damage. Point three, the ICNIRP guidelines followed by Public Health England are outdated and insufficient to protect public health. They ignore the vast amount of scientific findings that clearly and convincingly show harmful effects at intensities well below ICNIRP guidelines. Furthermore, ICNIRP disclaimed all liability on its website for any of its information, including its own guidelines. Point five, various councils in the UK, about 5 as it stands, have already opposed the rollout of 5G and have invoked the precautionary principle. Thank you.
Council is closely following the government's activities and working with Public Health England in monitoring the available evidence as 5G develops and will follow their advice if any concerns are raised. There's a lot of conflicting information circulating around potential health impact of 5G, and the council will endeavour to listen to the concerns raised. However, if it's safe to do so, we need to ensure that we're not economically or socially disadvantaged by not adopting 5G as it rolls out. The intention, therefore, is to set up a cross-party working group with a view to agreeing a council position on 5G and defining a strategy by assessing the evidence in respect to health and also covering areas such as planning permission and the potential use of council assets to assist in the rollout. Just worth noting that we did recently refuse a planning application for a 5G mast in Egremont. That was refused, but...
Kay, do you have a supplementary question?
Yes, I do, Mr. Mayor. Thank you so much. Can Council please advise as to how we can also move forward in inviting Council to also open up both children and families and environment overview and scrutiny committees to consider this important issue? I wish to present clear evidence of the risks to babies and children, specifically based on proven scientific theories. Children are especially vulnerable to microwave radiation because their nervous system and especially their brains are still developing. Their skulls are thinner and smaller than those of adults, so the radiation penetrates their brains more freely and deeply. Exposure to wireless frequency signals needs to be considered when looking at developmental, health, behavioural well-being and mental health issues in children and young people. The ICMIP guidelines followed by Public Health England do not reflect the scientific evidence and are not protective of human health. Babies, children and young people do not and cannot give informed consent to the damaging effect of wireless signals. They are dependent upon adults to safeguard them from harm. Interventions are needed to protect them from the harmful effects of wireless radio frequency signals. We need to introduce restrictions and safer wired technologies. France have banned Wi-Fi in nurseries and places of care for children under the age of 3 and has said that Wi-Fi must be switched off when not being used for educational purposes in all primary and middle schools. Many other countries are also taking similar precautions. References are available upon request. Thank you.
Free zones, dogs to be kept on leads in public places, etc., enabling everyone to enjoy open spaces. A simple question I'd like to ask, referring to the points mentioned, in this day and age, is the situation regarding lack of dog control on the world really acceptable? If this is the case, could someone please convince me why this is acceptable?
Thank you, Right, I would like to invite Councillor Liz Gray to respond.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Mr. Smith, I wish to assure you that Wirral Council is committed to making Wirral's open spaces great places all people to visit and enjoy. And to do so, we will be establishing appropriate dog control measures. I am sorry to hear about the bad experience your family endured on West Derby Beach last Christmas. And I understand that you and other residents are expecting a public spaces protection order, or PSPO, for dog control across Wirral. I can assure you that it remains our intention to introduce a PSPO for dog control, which will include a series of proportionate measures being established for identified locations and facilities. As we establish a PSPO, we will launch a public awareness campaign and erect signage and make clear our expectations for the use of open spaces by dog owners and their pets and non-dog owners. We've been working closely with Wirral Good Dogs campaign group and other local and national stakeholders to develop the measures for inclusion in the PSPO to ensure the measures proposed are accepted as necessary for all people's enjoyment of Wirral's fantastic open spaces. I'd like to thank you once again for your question after coming here tonight. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. Right, Mrs. Smithers, you have a right to ask a supplementary question.
I have one supplementary question. When I reported our RA Council of Dogs at West Kirby to the police on the 2nd of January, police reference 429-2119, I asked their advice about what to do if a similar incident occurred. Not that we had any intention of taking the family onto any World Beach the way things are. To quote the police, even small dogs can react when confronted. These dogs were out of control. Don't ring 101, ring 999. And an officer will attend and deal with the matter. My second question to you is, how would you convince my family, the way things are, to attempt another trip to West Kirby Beach?
Thank you, Mr. Councillor Gray, would you respond?
This will be considered as part of the work to prepare for PSPO for dog control in Wirral. We will look at good practice in neighbouring properties to ensure that our beaches are as clean and safe as they can be. I'd like to ask you to stay in touch as we continue to prepare the PSPO, and I'd like to thank you for taking the time for asking these questions over the next night. Thank you, Mr. Smithers.
Item 6 now, leader, executive members and chair's report. So item 6, on pages 49 to 82 of the agenda, contains a written report of the cabinet members and overview and scrutiny committee chairs. Cabinet members and scrutiny chairs will not present their report, which will be taken as read, and the council is invited to receive and note these reports. Now I would like to invite questions to cabinet members and scrutiny chairs in accordance with standing order 10, 2, 10 and 11. Can I remind members that you have 2 minutes to ask your question and that there will be a maximum total time limit of 45 minutes. I'd also like to remind members that your questions should be directly related to the content of the report. Okay. Do we have right. Councillor Chris Blakely.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Question to the Leader of the Councillor, then Leader of the Council, Councillor Pastakis. Does the Leader believe the comments of last week were overloaded regarding the council's response to the new bed explosion to be fair and accurate?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. If I just ask Councillor Blakely, the council, we've also give out cash to individual members of the community to help them through the trauma. We've also applied and been shortlisted for the future towns fund from government, and we'll hear about that shortly in the new year. We've also applied for SIP funding, that's Strategic Investment funding from the city region, and we'll hear about that very shortly as well. We've also applied for £500,000 from the City Region Metro Mayor's Fund, which has been successful, and we hope to have that very, very shortly. Run up the whole group at the moment, and I am personally chasing them. So there's been a combination of things, Mr. Mayor, that have helped the residents and businesses in the New Ferry recover from that trauma. And the council, I can assure you, Councillor Blakely, is doing all it can. Plans also to bring forward the regeneration of progress, as I said, well. And in partnership with Homes England, the council is working, as I said before, to assemble three sites on the Upper Chester Road in Pennington to the redevelopment of a mix of residential and retail units. This involves the acquisition of 18 properties and the land at 56 to 66 Pennington Road, which was cleared by the gas explosion. So, a number of things, as I said, are happening, and we are doing our best on behalf of the residents and businesses. And I personally met businesses and residents last Friday in the office in Hansham Hall as well. So be assured, we are doing our best. We know it's a slow process, but we are trying to do the process as quickly as possible. Thank you, Councillor Gordon.
Okay. Thank you, Councillor. I'm keen to facilitate as many questions as possible, so you know, can we keep our questions, our questions and answers short, please? Right. Just taking down some names, or just remain standing for a minute, please.